already becomes porridge, which means it's already happened and you can't change it. Zaki, why don't you give an example?
So I think example would be like in a rice cooker. But sir, I think we. So I think I can give two examples. Like the first one, maybe you lost a football match, right? And the second one.
Alif, focus. It's SPM this year. You wanna fail?
Don't worry, you know that our teacher is listening in class.
I don't really mind. Right?
Why is it so hard to get the promotion? I mean, I've been working for him for a while now. It's the least I could get, right? Oh, assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
How's school? Did you get in trouble again?
No, Dad, of course not, man.
Hey, I think you should stop watching that. I mean, what benefit do you get from watching that, huh?
What are you saying? Playing badminton is the only thing I'm good at. I love playing badminton. Besides, you're not around for most of the time, so...
What did you say? I've spent my whole life providing for this family, providing for you, and you're telling me I'm useless? I'm not the one who's daydreaming all day.
Daydreaming? One day, I will play professional badminton and win lots of tournaments, just to prove you wrong, Dad.
Look, son, the world's cool out there. I know you love badminton and all, but I'm sure your mom wants you to study instead of...
Don't you mention that. Please. She supported me, my hobby, and my dream. She comes to watch all my games, win or lose. Not you. Not in a million years.
You know, I'm really bad at this game, you know?
No, you're not. Come on. You're not that bad, bro.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, it's never a competition. Let's just have fun, bro.
You're gonna beat me up anyways.
Yeah. Of course I will. I will. So Hakim, do you want to serve first or let me serve? You serve first lah.
Damn it, Alif. Do you have to push that hard?
I mean, what can I say? I just play like normal.
In English?
Oh man.
Alif, may I have a word with you?
Now?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, sure.
Come on, let's go to the back.
See you.
Right. See you in class.
Alright. Alif.
Yes, sir.
You were very good out there. You were amazing. How would you like to represent the school for this upcoming badminton tournament?
Are you serious?
Yes, the tryouts are tomorrow.
Are you really giving me a chance right now?
Yes.
I'm interested.
So, you think you're ready to go?
I think, yeah, sure.
Why not? So, meet me tomorrow evening, right here at this court, yeah?
Right here. Okay, fine. Thanks. I will not let you down, sir.
Don't worry.
Thank you for the support.
Come on, Alif. Faster. This tournament's not going to be easy.
Okay, coach. Let's take it easy right now, okay? I'm tired. But I'm the best at the school. So, I already proved you right. So, can we take it easy? Please?
No. You got a lot of flaws, a lot of mistakes. You're not going to win like this.
Flaws?
Look, you got to stay grounded. You got to stay humble. You think your competition's going to be easy? It'll only be easy if he won't compete. I know a player who has massive potential.
That player, he is strong, big, relentless, and most importantly, he is swift.
He? Who is he?
I don't know much about that player, but he has a good track record in badminton. Enough jibber jabber, let's practice.
Flaws, huh?
Alif, stop. Are you okay?
I don't think so, coach. I don't feel good. I don't feel like I'm in my zone, you know? You know what I mean?
Tell me, what's the matter?
Just like you said, coach, I have a lot of flaws. I'm not cut out to play badminton. Now that I think about it, I do have a lot of flaws. It's about my dad, sir. He always say that I should focus on my studies rather than focus on the court. Maybe he is right. Maybe badminton is not for me.
Listen, you need to have a tad of self-respect, kid. To respect yourself, you need to accept all your flaws and imperfections. Nobody is perfect, even you. But that doesn't mean you can't strive. Frankly, you have the potential to become the best, but you need to stop complaining and start working.
Have faith and believe in yourself, Alif. I know you can do it. You just gotta keep working. And you're not working alone. You have me. Are you ready, Alif?
Yeah, I think so.
I think so? So you're not ready?
I mean, it just feels like my guts are convincing me that it's time to quit. But I guess it's too late right now, right? We're already here. So, let's go and win this.
Congratulations, kid. You're in the finals now.
Thank you, coach. Thank you. Let's go.
See you tomorrow,
let's go,
yeah?
Let's go.
Hello?
Hello. Is this Mr. Iskandar? I am Sir Hakim, Alif's teacher.
Well, hello there, Sir Hakim. Let me guess, you must have got in trouble again?
No, not at all. I just wanted to tell you that your son played well in the tournament and has advanced to the finals. And I think it'd be great if you can come and watch him play. It'll be a total morale boost for him.
Oh, I see. Well, I do have a tight schedule, you know, so like, I'll try to make time, yeah?
That is very generous of you, Mr. Iskandar. Have a nice day. Thank you.
All right, Sir Hakim, thank you and have a good day. Okay, yeah.
What's the matter now? What's gotten into you?
I don't know, sir. I feel like I can't win this. I'm no match for him.
Look, Alif, remember what brought you here. Remember all those hard days training, all the sweat and tears that fell to the ground? It was all because of you, your hard work and your determination. Now, I want you to give it one last go. At least, the least you can do is try your best and show them that you're the best. Come on, Alif. I believe in you. Let's do it. Come on. Let's go.
I'm the best. Let's go.
Alif, one more thing. Look up there.
Show who's boss, Alif.
Daddy's here. You're still gonna lose, kid. Come on.
Ha! We'll save our dad!
Ever since that day, everything negative inside of me changed into something, you could say, into more positive for me to be better. I could say that I achieved self-actualization as I found myself after that competition. I went to many tournaments and qualified for many championships. One of the best moments of my life was when I qualified for the Olympics and I won. A bronze medal. But to be honest, I couldn't live up to that Malaysian dream, you know, to go to Olympics and win the gold medal. But if I put my pride aside and look it into a brighter side, I could say I was very happy. Instead, I was very honored to represent our country, especially in the Olympics. My hope for all of you is to find yourself. And to find yourself, you need to dig inside of you and find who you truly are. In order to achieve that, you need to have a self-regard. A sense of admiration towards yourself would open up a lot of potential in you that you didn't notice. Also, instill assertiveness into your mind. Let people talk about what they want about you. Let them bring you down. But most importantly, you must and you should hold on to your own beliefs and your own principle so that you can achieve more in your life. Lastly, pursue on self-actualization. Discover yourself. Exceed your limit. Surpass your limits. Because at the end of the day, no one knows better you than yourself.
Mr. Yes? Alif, did you win the match?
The winner?
Your mom will be proud.